Welcome to Landria, Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through fears and live an awesome life. Oh, I have a little pressure headache coming on. All right. We are now going through a massive acceleration. Things are absolutely exploding for everybody. So whatever you're focused on, it's going to accelerate. What are you focused on? I hope it's giving. I hope it's not me, me, me. Me, me. What's, who can give me things to make me happy? How can I do things for you so I can get something? Yeah, that kind of giving. That's not the right kind of giving. That's not the kind that's going to ultimately make you happy. And I know you want to be super happy. I'm hearing such great feedback from you guys. You're sharing things with me that's like blowing my mind. Like I can actually hear the changes happening through these last 2 years of us working together. As of this video, it's been 2 years. And hearing you go from, can I do this, to I can do this. Or my parents didn't treat me well, to I forgave my parents. Oh, I'm so free now. You know, a load has been lifted and my life has changed. And, you know, this is going on here, but I need to take charge of my life and I'm going to do this. I'm not going to allow other people to keep me in a place that suits them and their fears. I'm taking charge of my life because I don't want to live my life in fear. So I'm not going to live under their rules anymore. I'm going to bless them. No anger. I'm going to walk away and say, thank you for being a part of my life. I have to go live my life. So what is your focus? And when I say, you know, the giving, you have to put everybody else first, I don't mean that you're not supposed to take care of yourself. You should go for living life and enjoying things and being human. And we have to start letting go of this concept of what, you know, being a good or spiritual person is. That's a separation again. We're all just here in the big melting pot of the oneness, all expressing ourselves. And you can make that whatever you want. There's a cause and effect. So just remember, whatever you do, there's going to be an effect. So if you want to go to the dark side, well, you're going to have to experience the effect from that. So that's okay. But I think most of you are ready to take it to the next level. And the next level, I mean, you know, you don't need to experience more suffering or know what it's like to go live in drama or chaos anymore. And that, you know, conflict is not something that's desirable anymore on this planet. And so your focus right now could be, what's my role here? I can flourish. I can enjoy life. I can have fun and have the things and whatever, but it's not what rules me. It's not what drives me anymore. And ask yourself, what is my focus? Is it worry every day? I just read something, somebody said their hobby was worrying. I said, you don't really mean that, do you? I think they did. They worry. That's what they do on the side. So, you know, that can be an addiction. Oh, this is biting, this getting me again. It's an addiction. Are you ready to give up the addictions? Addiction doesn't feel good. You know, you can never take enough of whatever it is you're addicted to feel good. So that's what makes an addiction. It never fulfills that empty hole. It's never filled up. It keeps getting deeper and wider and bigger and darker. So what can you let go of and focus on that could absolutely take you to a new place, a new place, a new way of thinking? What is your focus right now? What am I going to focus on? Is it just joy and peace? Is it just having joy and peace? And I know some of you are going, oh, talk to the hand. I'm not there. So, okay, let's focus on just being happy. What's that take? Let's focus on being prosperous. That's not the be-all, end-all, but let's get you out of a place of struggling. Prosperity. Let's get you prosperity. And that may not just be money. Maybe it's just, you know, things flowing, positive things flowing in your life, abundance of all kinds. You know, let's focus on abundance, abundance, abundance. There's always enough in the world. So then put your focus on that. There's always enough. I know this for a fact. I always have what I need. I always have everything I need. And I get sometimes just things that I want. Pretty much all the time. Yeah, if I think about something, it shows up. Here's something. You know, all you have to do is think of something and it shows up. Do you know how many stores I've been to and I've never seen anything like this? I wanted the little cutouts. So I went to a church fair because I love giving and I wanted to support them. And they were selling things from other countries that help support those countries. So I bought some good things and I found these absolutely adorable little gloves with the, because you know, it doesn't get that cold here in Atlanta. So if it does get chilly, I like to get my hands, but I like to have the fingers out, right? Sometimes you just have to think of something. So I ordered some UGG boots because they're really cozy. And they didn't show up for like a week. And so I called them and I said, you know, what's going on? They were in stock. Why is it taking so long? They said, oh, they actually weren't in stock. So because they didn't ship, I got a discount that happened the day after I ordered. They gave me a $75 gift certificate. Because it didn't, because it was back ordered, and I would have gotten that certificate if I'd have waited to order it. Because they weren't in stock anyways, I might as well have waited, right? So they gave me $75. Everything happens for a reason. So what appears sometimes to not be so good, you'd be shocked at how good it's going to be for you. So let's focus on everything that happens to me is good. Everything. I stubbed my toe. On my way to the car. Oh, maybe you take a 60 seconds and you're hopping around going, doggone, that hurt. And in that 60 seconds, you don't even know it. You missed a car accident that you would have been in. And some force delayed you by having you stub your toe. That seemed like a bad thing. Everything's happening. I hurt my toe and I didn't get in the car on time or leave when I wanted to. Everything's happening for your good, your best, highest good, everything. And that is the truth, by the way. So if you saw a video that I shot with my partner, business partner, Kevin Moore, who's a talk show host in the UK, he's filming a documentary. He and I are doing a television series, and we both decided to shoot a little video for you. And bottom line is, we both agree that even when things seem like they're not going well, that is the absolute best thing for you. Now, if you continue to stay in a negative space in your mind, things will continue to come to you because you're not learning the lesson to get out of it. You're thinking you're in a bad place. You're not seeing it as a positive thing. You're not seeing the universe giving you the best, highest possible, path to what's best for you. So why don't you focus on that? Let's say everything that happens to me is for my best possible outcome. Everything. And guess what? The message to the universe is that, oh, okay, well, we don't have to send any more screwball lessons anymore because everything that happens is good. Right? So we don't have to start sending messages because this person is, you know, suffering or sad or hasn't learned how to forgive or hasn't learned how to be happy on their own. So we're going to send them all kinds of challenges because that's what they're sending out is worry, challenges, sadness. So we're going to keep giving that until they figure out they can get out of that anytime they want. So when they start to focus on happiness, everything that happens to me. So let's say you can't be happy right now. Just say, accept the fact, everything that happens to me is good. Maybe I'll name the video that. Everything that happens to me is for my best outcome. Is the best thing that could happen to me. Everything. Everything. So Kevin and I tried to pull something together months ago, and it didn't happen. And I didn't care about that because I knew that if it was supposed to happen, because he and I have the best possible intentions. We always want things to be the best possible thing for other people. Our whole thing is to really make a difference in this world. and we've teamed up forces, and it came back together months later in the best possible way. But because we were okay with the fact that it wasn't coming together when we wanted it to, it just wasn't happening for whatever reason, when it finally came back, it came back at the best way it could to us, so for us. So what happened before, a few months ago, when, you know, you could have been disappointed and said, well, we wanted this and that to happen, it wasn't. And then all of the pieces started to pull together. And now it's happening the best possible way. So if we'd have pushed that, it wouldn't have worked out the same way. In fact, it probably would have failed, and then we'd be back at ground zero again. So everything that happens for you is the best possible thing for you. The best. Get ready. Something great is coming. Something great is coming. If I stub my toe, oh, I avoided a car accident, right? We don't know, but assume that everything has a reason. Everything has a reason. All right? So if, you know, if you're off in some la-la land worrying and whatever, and, you know, a tree falls through your house, maybe you were supposed to get that thought disrupted. You get my drift. So can you focus on everything is happening to you for the best reason? There is nothing bad in this universe. Nothing. It doesn't exist. It's just an experience. That deep, dark, whatever it is eventually going to end up back in the highest frequency again. It's going there to experience something, and you probably have been there too. Just because you're like some enlightened being in this lifetime doesn't mean you haven't been to that dark side. I guarantee you have. You know why? We're all one, so we have experienced it. We've been the murderer. We've been the murdered. We've been the liar and the cheat and the thief. We've been the saint. We've been the persecuted. We've probably been every culture and every color. So be careful with that one too, if you think you're all that. This is, as Kevin said, a spacesuit. So, what are you going to focus on? Focus on that thing, and you focus on it every moment. You catch yourself, and when you start to worry, you say, everything's happening exactly as it's supposed to, because it's going to take me to that incredible place that you want to be at. Joy, financial security, abundance, loving relationships, giving, making a difference in this world, helping others, feeling really good about it, feeling like you have a purpose and a meaning, and all of this prosperity is going to come to you because you're a giving person that doesn't feel lack. We're ready for that now, aren't we? How many more videos do you have to watch before you decide that you're going to start thinking and feeling like the giving, loving person that you are? It's today. Where's your focus? Everything that happens to me is for the best of for me. The best possible pathway, the best possible scenario for me. And I get to choose where I get taken. I get to choose prosperity. I get to choose joy. And I accept the fact that all of these lessons are getting me there. And I'm ready to embrace it instead of fighting everything, fearing everything, worrying about everything, afraid you're not going to get enough, cynical. That's the ego. Somebody's out after you. Somebody's got more than you. Get over it. Nobody has more than you. No one. And if you think somebody has it made out there, take another look. Every single person has their challenges. All of them. And even though I chose a very awesome life and very, very incredible positive relationships along the way, starting with my beautiful, wonderful parents and my brother, awesome, awesome people, supported me 100%, loving, no drama, usual silly little family stuff maybe, you know, the growing up pains, but no drama. Why? I needed that platform to do what I'm going to do in this lifetime because I made a commitment and I'm fulfilling it. You don't have to fulfill your commitments. You're going to eventually have to, so you better do it now. You better give. You better be loving. You better be your best. You better get off that couch and start living that life and embracing all of the abundance that's coming to you, waiting for you, always there, already created. Nothing can be created nor destroyed. It all exists. You get to pull it into your reality, and that's through focus. What are you going to focus on? I have everything I need and more. Everything that comes to me is for my best, highest good. And everything is resulting in something beautiful and joyful and abundant. You'll never lack for anything. You don't lack for anything now. It's not about the material world. When you don't lack, that material world is going to fold in on you and roll in all the riches of the world, because there's no limit to abundance. There is no limit to abundance. There should never be poverty or, you know, people going hungry or people lacking love. It's all self-created experiences. That's okay. And it doesn't have to be you. Are you done with it? Yes, yes. You are whole, perfect, strong, powerful, loving, harmonious, and you are truly happy. Embrace it. You are a miracle worker. I don't have to send you miracles. You're the miracle worker. You're the miracle worker. Make it happen. Namaste.